quick back air. Hello, Reyes. How you doing, dude? Can't do that. I think Fox or Falco is the harder character. I always see Falco. No bias. Fox gets to mash more. I feel like Falco kind of has to... Like, once you get past that level, you can't just mash. That's Falco. Yeah. That's my fault. Fox isn't carried. Fox is a hard-ass character. Especially to do well with at, like, top level. But he also is some bullshit. He's definitely, like, right next to that group of, like, top-tier bullshit. Maybe one rung below. But he's, like, very close. Very close to just, like, stupid busted top tier. His fragility is the only thing that keeps him in the game as, like, a... I don't know, high-tier hero. You just gotta auto-cancel and fast-fall at the right times. And then, like, the huge mix is just sometimes empty hop with that, and it'll freak people out. No, I play a couple characters, but in tournament, it's pretty much Falco, yeah. I think I stuck to solo Falco for a long time. This still counts if I zero to death, by the way. What the fuck was I just talking about with Falco, man? God damn it. Alright, like a semi-JV4. Falco in advantage sometimes can press buttons. And just fucking mash his pressure out. In defense, though, that's where I feel like defense becomes really tough for a character like Falco. Because we're as slow as we are on the ground. Closing distance could be tough when people are trying to keep you out, especially. Fucking summoners, man. He could be a little. He's fast in certain instances. I think, as you said, most of the time the speed factor is only noticeably bad when you're getting, like, zoned out or camped out. People are playing far away from you. Why can't anyone do normal? Back here, bro. Yeah, I'm sure you will. Sure you will. Yeah, I fucking, I know you're good, bro. Get out of here. Yeah. Shield pressure and falling there. Yeah, I think the mix up between there and fair helps, because it just forces people to mix up their shield timing if they're trying to parry and shit. Then down air comes in, it's like the chaotic option. I think it's worth to go, dude, always go for edgeguards. There's very few characters who you shouldn't go for edgeguards on. Like, most of the time, it's just run off and hit them, however you can. Usually fair or neutral air. But if you could find the dares, bro, go for it. Ledge trapping's also busted. I think the best edgeguards are ones that set you up to ledge trap anyway. Just in case you miss. Cross up the fucking... Oh. Pure fear, man. And they always just float, like, right outside of your range. I tried to fucking footstool. When people try to force that aggression too, that's when you want to like try to throw something out at ledge. That early dare to sour spot, the late dare if you're like confident like in that case, or just fair if you're not sure but you think they're gonna jump, just cover mad space. Even it catches neutral getups on tall characters, so it's useful in other ways too. the TLDR, bro. If you're getting zoned out, just go in for some Hail Mary run-in grabs occasionally. Especially if they're shielding after most whiffs, right? I played him as a kid in Melee a little bit, because I thought he was cool. I grabbed his knockdown in Melee because I just, like, it was clunky and I mashed. In Brawl, he was the first character I picked up. I mean, I just like him. I think I liked him and Fox a lot throughout the series. I always played him, either him and a little bit of Fox, or Fox and a little bit of him. It's just the species, like, I guess the archetype is what attracts me the most. They're just fast, they're very combo-based. I like damage. I like stacking up 100 damage in like 10 seconds. And the characters that do that are either like Steve, Bowser Jr., many other like characters I dislike, or Falco. And with Falco I could like kind of I could do different shit most of the time. Not just the same like zero to death combo that always comes out. Drag down fair to down smash. It's true. Okay, so drag down fair to up tilt, up smash, and down smash pretty much mostly will work on light characters that are tall. So I think if they're below 100 weight, and if they're above a certain height. Now, Falco gets hit by it, so it's about like Falco height. Fox doesn't, because he's too short. And he's a fast faller, I might mess with it too. Like most heavies, you'll notice up tilt, drag down anything into up tilt doesn't always work because they fall so fast that they can shield already on the ground by the time your move comes out. Light characters take more time to get to the ground. So when you drag down, they're still stuck in that little like air lag. Future Falco looks like the same, bro. I think he'll get slightly better, if not stay exactly where he is on the list. In the meta. I think the meta was at a good point for him recently. I think right now it might be heading more towards like another slow pace wave instead of like these DLCs just dominating. I don't know. I feel like Falco is comfortable in the meta. I don't think he's moving drastically in either direction. But I think he's in a solid spot for me. I think my down tilt game is getting so much better. I just think I'm not optimal in a lot of what I do sometimes. I just kind of play by feel, and I feel like if I get a little more optimal in some areas, like, I could make Falco better still. I don't think I'm doing the best I can do as a player, which means I think Falco's ceiling is higher than I've already, like, made it. I think the important part about Falco as a character for me is I think he has a high ceiling. That's probably the biggest reason I play Falco low-key. Like, he's one of the only combo-heavy, pretty mix-up based, slash has a frame run reflector and can handle zoners really well characters that, like, his ceiling's high as fuck. We haven't reached the ceiling yet. There's so many low tiers that, like, what makes someone a low tier is it forces them in this place of, like, a low ceiling. Your floor, your ceiling. Eventually, you can't get any better because your character just sucks. Falco is not like that, though. He has so much change and mix-up that's possible. Which makes his ceiling just feel like it doesn't stop growing when I play him. feel like I'm gimping people in new ways like every day. That shit just keeps flowing, man. There's more to discover. Like, up tilt's so good. I just negated his move by anti-airing that shit with an up air, up tilt, and then it forces him into like, are you gonna get up air, back air, or air dodge? And he dies for like all three. Yeah, all of our moves linger. That's another thing. We have some long ass moves, man. Fair's stupid with how long it's out. And then two other aerials are out just as much. Which makes edge guarding a lot easier. Because you can occupy space nonstop.